Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Today we're talking about Sculptra, and one of the areas where people fail with Sculptra is clogging. The other area is the slow onset of results. It goes in as a water, which is a beautiful thing because we can blanket areas of the face where we can't use hyaluronic acid fillers because of expense and demarcating lines. So that's a matter of holding the patient's hand through as the water resorbs and it builds up slowly, but it's a culture within the practice. Clogging, on the other hand, is an issue that providers can't get over and they get frustrated. So we're gonna go through that today. Now, the vial of Sculptra contains mannitol, of course the PLLA, and carboxymethyl cellulose. And that last one is what clogs the needle. Now, we of course draw it up with an 18 gauge needle. Many people do various different things to help avoid clogging. They warm it, they agitate it, they shake it, they do all kinds of crazy things. It's very simple to avoid clogging. I'm gonna demonstrate it here where we swirl the vial, and that's to agitate the particles on the bottom of the vial. And then we simply turn the vial upside down and we let it sit there for about 15 seconds. And this allows the carboxymethyl cellulose to rise to the top. And when we use the 18 gauge needle to extract the product, we go from the middle of the fluid. And this avoids the clogging carboxymethyl cellulose. And then we use a 25 gauge, 1.5 inch needle most commonly, or a short 26 gauge needle to inject. You will never have a clog after doing this. There's no need to warm it. There's no need to do any other agitation or use large 23 or 21 gauge needles to inject Sculptra with. So clogging isn't something you have to live with. It's not part of Sculptra. It's a matter of getting rid of that carboxymethyl cellulose in the vial and using just pure PLLA, because remember, the PLLA beads themselves are about 42 to 63 microns in size. That's very small and shouldn't cause a clog, but of course the carboxymethyl cellulose that we want to get rid of will. Lastly, when you take the Sculptra, you don't take the very last drop. Everyone wants to get every little bit out of the vial. It's not designed that way. Look how much is in the vial. Look how many milligrams are in there. It's an odd number. You're not meant to get the last 0.5 to 1 cc out of the bottom. And lastly, concentrations. Of course, everyone asks this. I use anything from 5 cc concentration all the way to 36 cc concentrations. So that's part of the art of Sculptra that we'll talk about another time. I hope that helps. Join me on this YouTube channel. Ask questions below for further tips to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.